illustrate how to compute the mean and the standard deviation of a discrete probability distribution. Imagine that we have a dice game. And this dice game consists in the following. You pay $3 to play. And then you win $1 times the value on the die. That means that if you, for example, obtain number 6, then you are going to obtain $6. Your payoff obviously will be 6 minus 3, only $3. But if you obtain number 5, then your payoff will be $5 that you obtain, minus 3 will be $2 your payoff. Okay, so to compute the expected payoff or the expected value of this random variable and its standard deviation will be a good idea to compute first. So to see first the probability distribution. And remember, the probability distribution have, you need to list all the possible values and all its probabilities. For example, I noticed that the possible value of the payoff will be the random variable. But one possible value is minus 2 for sure. That happened when you obtain number 1. When you toss the die and you obtain number 1, you get only $1. But because you pay already 3, 1 minus 3, you are losing $2. So it will be your payoff is negative 2. Another possible payoff will be negative 1. And that will be when you obtain number 2 in the die. So you obtain $2, but because you pay 3, 2 minus 3, you are losing $1. You break even if you obtain three in the die. 3 minus 3, because you pay 3, will be 0. So your payoff will be 0, but your payoff will be $1. And that was the case when you obtain 4 in the die. 4, and for the 4, your 4 minus 3, $1. And you can obtain as a payoff $2 and or $3. $2 in the case that you get 5, or $3 in the case that you get 6. Okay, so this is part of the probability distribution, but the probability distribution also need to list all the probability of each value. But you notice here that the probability of each value is the same, because for each of these expected value is actually correspond, for this value correspond exactly a one to one of the probably outcomes when you toss a die. So it means that if you make another column for the probabilities, then the probability of minus 2 is actually the probability of obtaining 1 in the die, and you know that is 1/6. Or if the probability of this is the probability of obtaining 2 is 1/6 also. Probability of obtaining 3 corresponds to this 0 is 1/6. So each of these probability will be 1/6. 1/6 is 0.16667, so we're gonna write here the same probability of all of them, for all of them. So each of these values have the same probability, and if you add together all these values, you have to check if we are doing well. Okay, obviously the answer will be 1. So the total will be 1. Okay, now let's see how to compute the expected payoff. The expected payoff, remember, is the mean, and the mean, the formula is this, yeah? The mean will be the sum of all the products, xpx. So you need to multiply x times px. So the value times the probability of the value. So for example, for this value, minus 2 times the probability of the value. So it will be a good idea to make another column with this value, the x times the probability of x. And at the end, we add together all this product because the formula tells me that I need to sum all these values, all these results. So let's see, let's multiply xpx in each of the cases. So minus 2 times 0.1667 in your calculator, this is negative, this is positive, you get a negative number, negative 0.3333. Yeah? Now for the next one will be negative 1 times this number, 0.16667. So the answer it will be, obviously, you multiply by 1, but the answer is negative, negative 0.16667. This is very easy, 0 times 0.16667, so the answer is 0. This will be 1 times 0.16667, the answer is 0.1667. Obviously, so then you do the same in each case, x times the probability. Here is 2 times 0.1667, and here is 3 times 0.167. So the answer here is 0.333, and the answer here is 0.5. So I'm using all the numbers in my calculator. That is actually the real answer here was 0.1666666. So I rounded to 4 decimals, the values. Okay, adding together all these numbers, the answer will give you the mean. And this is the formula. Adding together all the values, XPX, the answer will be the mean. So add together all these numbers. It will be easier here. You can use your calculator, but you notice here that this cancels this with this. This cancels this with this. This is positive, this is negative. So this is zero, so the answer is 0.50. Obviously, you can use your calculator and add all these numbers. The answer is 0.50, and that gives you the answer of the mean. So what does it mean? It means that if you play this game, you are going to earn in average $0.50 per game. So sometimes you are going to lose $2, sometimes you're going to win 3, sometimes you're going to win 2, sometimes you're break even. But in average, if you play infinite number of times, will be 0.50. Obviously, you cannot play infinite number of times, but you can play for many, many, many times. And if you play many, many, many times, the answer will be close to 0.50. So this is a good game to play. If this was a real game, it will be a good idea to play. Obviously, maybe that doesn't exist. This is an example of how to use the expected payoff. Yeah. So what is the expected value of a random variable? Okay, because you don't obtain always the same. Yeah. Sometimes you will lose. Sometimes you win. That means that there is a variation in your answer. So because there is a variation, you want to measure this variation to compare with an other game, for example. If you want to compare the variation, this will be actually useful to compare the risk of this game. So if you want to compare this variation, it would be ideal to use the variance. Let's compute the variance, because I need to compute the variance before computing the standard deviation, remember. And the formula of the variance is this. Sorry, this is the answer of the expected value. The formula of the variance is this. Remember, it's the sum of the x minus the mean. This is another symbol for the mean. This you can use expected value, or you can say mean. And if you remember, this is the same symbol that we use in the statistic for the population mean, yeah? Okay, so will be the value minus the mean and square the value and multiply by px. So after you go all this result, you need to add together. This is the sum of all this number. So it will be a good idea to make another column for this product, x minus mu squared times px. Let's do another column. And this column we have x minus mu, the value minus the mean. The mean is, remember, is 0.15. And multiply by px, by the probability, and the probability is always here, yeah? This column. So for the first, for example, for the first value will be the value is minus 2, this is x, minus 0.5, this is 1, negative 2.5 square, because they say that they need to square, and multiply by 0.1667. So that give me, let me see, 1.042. Let's type this 1.042, and let's do now with the next one. Minus 1 times 0.50, this is minus 1.50. Minus 1.50 squared, now I get a positive number, yeah? And then multiply by 0.16667. And the answer is, let's see, 0.375. Again, for the next one, The value minus 0.5, they will be negative 0.5. Negative 0.5 square, positive 0.25, and then multiply by 0.16667. And the answer I get, it was 0.042. Let's do again, let's do the same with the next one. Will be the value minus the mean, 1 minus 0.50 squared 0.25, also the same answer. Multiply by this number, the answer is 0.042. Let's see the next one. Will be the value minus the mean. You check that what we are doing is exactly what they say here to do, that I need to do. The value minus the mean, and then square the answer, and then multiply by px. Let's see. The value 2 minus 0.50 square, and this. For example, for this one will be 3 minus 0.50 square, and multiply by this. So these answers are 0.375 and 1.042. So if I want to know the variance, that I need to do is just add together, see the symbol here, sum, all these products. Yeah? So I need to add together all this number. If we add together all this number, the answer is 1.042 plus 0.375 plus 0.042 plus 0.042 plus 0.375 plus 1.042. And the answer that I get is 2.917. So I have the value for the variance. But the question was not the variance. The question was, what is the standard deviation? And we know that the standard deviation is just the square root of the variance. So the standard deviation will be the square root of 0.917. And this square root, you use the key square root for the number, and then the standard deviation that I obtain is 1.71. And that's the way that you compute the mean and the standard deviation or a discrete random variable. If you have questions, you can write this in your comments, or you can email me with a question. Don't forget to like if you really understand the topic using this video, and subscribe if you want to know when a new video is coming. Okay, thank you for your attention, and please check if there are more videos with problems like this. Thank you.